Hello everyone and welcome back to Geek Disorder's series on HTML5, CSS3, JavaScript, and jQuery. This is Lavik. I'll be walking you through the series. This is video number 6. We're going to be discussing some web development issues that you need to be aware of. It'll be our last video like this before we actually jump into making some web pages. Okay, well in web development there are three special issues you need to be aware of. First one is cross-browser compatibility. Second is user accessibility, and third is search engine optimization, or SEO as it's called. Well, with cross-browser compatibility, what that means is you want to make sure that your web pages are compatible with as many browsers as you can. So if you're developing a web page for the public, you want to make sure that if they're using IE, Firefox, or Chrome, Opera, anything like that, you want to make sure that your browser works correctly in every single one of those. Now if you're making a web page for your business and everyone in your business uses IE and no one else outside of your business is going to take a look at that web page, you don't have to worry about it. Just develop for IE, but most of the time for the public you want to make sure that you have cross browser compatibility. Next is user accessibility. You'll want to make sure that your web pages support features that make it accessible to as many users as you can, especially disabled users. So you know, if someone has a handicap where they can't see very well, you want to make sure that certain like images are tagged correctly so they know what those images are, especially if they contain words and what those words are. Next you have search engine optimization, or SEO. Understanding how SEO works will help make sure your web pages are ranked higher in a search engine. So if you're making a web page over like the rainforest, someone searches rainforest, you want to try to get your web page in the first two pages, because that's most people don't go past the second page. Most people don't go past the first page, but you want to make sure that you get your web page as close to the first page as you can, if not on the first page. Okay, cross-browser compatibility. Of course, you want to make sure your web page is compatible with as many browsers as you can. You'll want to test your web pages in all major browsers and all versions of those browsers that are still in common use. None of the major browsers fully support HTML5 yet, but all of the major browsers currently support the most popular features. You can see what features of HTML5 and CSS3 that your browser or any other browser supports at www.html5test.com. There are workarounds for older browsers that don't support HTML5 and CSS3, and we'll cover as many of those as we can as we come to them. And then we have user accessibility. What this is you want to make sure your web page supports features that make it accessible to as many users as you can, especially disabled users. There are three accessibility laws that you should know of: Section 255 of the Telecommunications Act of 1996, Sections 504 and 508 of the Federal Rehabilitation Act, and the Americans with Disability Act, or ADA. Some helpful resources when working with user accessibility is the accessibility guidelines from the W3C at, of course, this link right here, w3.org/WCAG. Then we have the W3C also has a specification called the Web Accessibility Initiative Accessible Rich Internet Applications, or WAIARIA, and it can be found at the www.w3.org/tr/WAI-ARIA. That's quite a mouthful. Okay, and then we have the Web AIM. It's a good place to get some good information on accessibility. It's a good place probably to start, and it's www.webaim.org. Okay, we have search engine optimization. Understand how SEO works will help you make sure your web page pages are ranked higher in a search engine. Get some closer or onto the first page. HTML5 provides some new elements that will help search engines deliver results that are more relevant to your website. So if someone searches rainforest, hopefully, you know, using those elements will help your web page get closer to the first page or on the first page. This series will include some tips over SEO, but SEO is a very in-depth subject, so you'll want to really do some outside research on the internet, books and stuff like that, if you're really wanting to promote your website. All right, well, thank you for joining Geek Disorder. This, of course, our next video, we're actually going to jump in and start making some web pages. We're going to go over the structure of a web page. So, if you like the video and want to keep seeing more, please subscribe, like, and share us, and y'all have a good day.